Welcome to my Unreal Engine 4 tutorial series on how to make a skill tree. And in today's episode, we're gonna make a functionality to hover the skill tree and make your skill details visible. And what we did in the last tutorial, we have this toggle skill on and off, and we have made this UI. And if you hit 4 to get XP, you can see our XP is increasing in runtime, and we have one player's level is 1, and we have currently 2 skill points. So in this tutorial, we're gonna make a functionality to hover these effects. So how are we gonna do that? So first thing first, in your event graph or skill tree, construct event. So event construct, you have this on your event graph, right? Just cast to your player character. Third person I'm using. And from the object reference, get your player object reference. So get player character. Yep. And promote it to variable. Just we call this player, whatever you want. And get a skill tree UI. So first we're gonna grab a skill tree component and also promote this into a variable. We're gonna call this skill tree component. Yep. And we gonna promote a third variable, and that would be your skill tree. So skill tree UI, we have just made it in your skill tree component. Just promote this to a variable and we gonna call this skill tree. Yep, just hit back to here. Okay, so we have promoted these three variables. After that, let's make this a function to get all the skills variable in a certain place. So our skill tree component will keep track of all the widgets. So how are we gonna do that? So let's make a function and call this get skilled status, something like this. Make an input, and the input would be a skill. So e skills, and type of is the enumeration we have just made in previous class, e_skill, the enumeration. Yep. And in the output node, what we're gonna need, we need a success node. So if it's acquired or not, so success, and this would be a boolean. So if it's true or false. Yep. So if our skill is currently owned, then this will set you your skill is currently owned, and if it's not, then if it's not owned, something like this. So what we need, we need to select it. So just hit and grab this select node, and you can see this option 1 and option 2, it's based on whatever the return value, it will change its value. So you can see this diamond pin, there are 3 or 4 types of pin in Unreal, I'm not sure. First is this green, this round pin. This round pin is for references. So you can use it very often, from just attach it component and reference it, so it will work sequentially from left to right. The second node is this diamond, half diamond, or let's say this triangle and something white node. This is execute node. You can see the tooltip exec. This is the main node of how the workflow gonna look like from left to right. So it will gonna look like from here to here, from left to right. The third is this diamond shape. You can see this diamond shape area. This is wildcard. It will change the parameters of it accordingly on whatever it connected to. And there is another node called, let me show you real quick. So in here you can see this square red, this is event node. So if you want to attach an event, then this is red square node, and there are multi other, but we don't need that. So we are satisfied with this, and grab this skill, and if you attach it, you can see it will change its value. So you can attach any variable in this pin, because it is a wild card. So if you attach, you can see it change to double jump. And where is this double jump come from? It fr come from this enumeration we have just created this. So we have only the double jump. If we add another skill called sprint slide, let's say sprint slide, whatever you want, slide, you can add space, but this is my naming convention. So whatever, and if you hit compile, so you can see there are two nodes. So how do you gonna do that? So add a variable, call this double jump, and type of this variable would be a boolean, and let's categorize it to skills. Hit compile, and now you can add this default value in here. So if you grab and add this to double jump, it would be added. So if you have 50 skills, pardon, then you have to make 50 this variables boolean, but you have to code this all once. You don't have to code this all alone, so just do it once and it will be good. Let's make another boolean and call this sprint slide. You cannot use space in variable naming. Make sure the default value is false and attach it to here. Hit compile and save, and let's in here skill slots, grab your skill tree component and get skill status, the function we have just made. The e skills would be this enumeration, this skill, to get the skills and attach it to here. And from that, the success would be go to your is owned. So get and set is owned, and this would go to your success node. After that, we're gonna refresh our skill points. So how do you gonna refresh it? Make a function, call it refresh slot. What we gonna function do is, if our skill point are owned, so if we unlocked our skill, if our current skill is unlocked, then the border will be golden. If our current skill is available to learn but it is not owned by us, so the current border would be white. And if our skill is not owned and also it is not available for us to unlock, then the skill border would be white but the opacity would be 0.7. So how are we gonna do that? So add a branch and let's see if it's owned or not first. So if it's owned, if it this is true, then we're gonna set is this skill slot border. So get the skill slot border and set color, set brush color to golden. Click on this black icon and golden. Oh, where is this golden color? Oh no. I think this is golden color, yeah. I'm satisfied with it. And set the render opacity of this widget, the slot widget, to 1. So set render opacity this to 1. Yep. If it's no false, so add a branch. So if it's not owned but it is available to us, so get available, attach it to here. And if it's available to us, then what we're gonna do, we're gonna set this skill border. So Control W to duplicate that, and we're gonna set the skill border to pure white. So I have already saved my pure white color, just hit OK. And the opacity would be word, and set color and opacity because we need that. And you can see this color and opacity of this current widget, and this is for our border. So right click and you can see this split screen. So in this blue, if you right click, you can see this please split structure pin. Why this is something like this, combine it. I didn't know if it looks like this. Oh, we don't need that actually. We need that, but not now. Just Control W. And if our skill is neither owned or neither available to us, then we're gonna set this opacity to 0.7 because it works fine for me. So it will gonna something invisible. And let's refresh slot. So let me show you a quick look on how this gonna look. What I'm going to show is hit tab. You can see all the color of the, okay. We have to set that. So on your refresh slot, grab a skill, where was this? This skill icon, set color and opacity. Yep, this one. And make it to something like white. I think this might work, or we don't need that actually. So you can see, let me make show you a quick look. So you can see this is our skill which is available to us. So it is look pure white, and this is, these skills are not available. So they look a bit darker, the gray shade. Let me make this up in PIE so you can see it very well. You can see this, this is pure white and this is something darker. So these skills are not available. Yep, make again to selected viewport and just stop it. After that, let's make a mouse hover functions. So if our mouse hover is on, then we're gonna set, so mouse enter. So there is a mouse enter event. If our mouse enter event is true, then what we're gonna do, we're gonna set our borders. So set skill border, and we're gonna set the border color to something like red. But this we're gonna do only if our border is not owned. So how are we gonna do that? So let's me give you a quick look. So set border color. Not this, set color actually, set brush color. Yep, this one. So set this brush color to red because it is our themes, and you don't have to match it. You must have to match your theme colors properly. You don't want to use different colors. There is another function called mouse left, or what was the function, mouse leave, sorry. So whenever our mouse leave, we're gonna set this border back to white. Yep, this. Hit compile and save, and let's see if it's working or not. If we hit play, if we hit tab, you can see this little hovering effect. Don't worry about the border if it's right side bit more in, because it's gonna work fine. Yep, so we have done this, and everything is done now for this tutorial. So what we need is, we need to set some values for to binding, and then after we gonna do our interaction part. So on your designer, click on this skill icon. And here you can see this brush, and you can see this create a binding. Create binding. Get texture from material. So make brush from texture. You can see this, make brush from texture. And what would be this brush be? This skill icon image. Make sure you can set this skill item image, not this skill icon. And add it to here. Hit compile and save, and this is done. And in your skill tree UI, this one, make some variables. So let's make first variable and call this t underscore skill status. Always follow the naming convention because in the programming it is very important. And the type would be a text type. We don't need this instance editable. Okay, just duplicate that. Sorry, Control W to duplicate, and the next variable would be our skill name. Skill name. Yep. Duplicate skill description. Description. Yep. And also duplicate, and this would be our skill required points. Yep, so we have our four variables, and this skill required points would be a text, and I will show you why this is text in next episode. So let's bind this. So the skill status, this text would be your skill status, the T underscore skill status. This would be your skill name. This would be your skill description. This one, and this would be your skill require points, this one. Okay, simple. And make the size box make this to horizontally center, and make this width layout, sorry, the make this in here, and let's set the padding of left to 15 and right to 15, so it looks good, it looks more, I mean, eye-catching. Yeah, I don't find the better words because my vocabulary are bad. So you can see we have bind and we have set it to none, so it won't show up, but we're gonna do this in next episode, and you can see our hover effects. So thank you so much guys for watching, and bye bye.